Good morning, students. In previous lecture, we have completed the chemical reactions of matters. In today's lecture, we will talk about the most important topic of this chapter, that is matter reactivity series. Two or three questions in your board examination are always set from this topic. So let us start the topic metal reactivity series. Do all metals have the same reactivity? Then the answer is simply no. All metals do not have same reactivity. Like sodium and potassium reacts with cold water. If you place a piece of sodium or potassium in cold water, then it will start reacting. The released gas H2 will catch fire. But on the other hand, magnesium does not react with cold water, it requires hot water. It means magnesium is less reactive than sodium and potassium. And if we talk about aluminium and iron, then aluminium and iron neither reacts with cold water nor reacts with hot water, but on the other hand it reacts with steam or water vapor. It means the reactivity of aluminium and iron is less than magnesium. That's why increase of temperature is required. Cold water, then hot water, and then water vapor. Hence we can say that all metals do not have same reactivity. Some reacts faster, while other reacts with moderate or slow rate. So based on their reactivity, we can arrange these metals in the form of a series. And this series is called metal reactivity series. So the definition is the arrangement of metals in the decreasing order of their reactivity is called metal reactivity series. I have arranged few important metals in the decreasing order of their reactivity and I have obtained the metal reactivity series. The few important metals are potassium, followed by sodium, then calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, hydrogen, copper, silver and gold. So if a metal is present on the left hand side, then it will be more reactive than the metal present on right hand side. So here I can say that calcium is more reactive than magnesium because calcium is located on left hand side in the metal reactivity series. Now the important question or the important point. Here I have written hydrogen, which is a non-metal, but still it is included in the metal reactivity series. The reason is very simple. Hydrogen also exhibits some electropositive character. Like metals are electropositive in nature, metals by losing electrons form cations. In the similar manner, hydrogen by losing one electron gets converted to H plus ion. That's why it is included in metal reactivity series. So metals on the extreme left are highly reactive, while the metals on the extreme right are least reactive. So the least reactive metals are copper, silver and gold. Silver and gold, as these are the least reactive metals. That's why for making jewelry, silver and gold are used. And these are least reactive, these metals do not undergo corrosion. For the reaction with the atmospheric gases. So it remains in the pure form and maintaining their lustrous nature or shiny surface. Then comes the importance of metal reactivity series. We have two very important applications or importance of metal reactivity series. The first application is whether the metal will be able to displace hydrogen in the form of H2 gas from dilute acid solution or not. And application number second, or importance number second, is whether the metal will be able to displace another metal from its salt solution or not. For explaining the two applications, I will be using some chemical reactions here. Clear? So, for application first, I have written here two chemical reactions. Zinc solid or zinc granules when mixed with aqueous H2SO4. Then whether the release of H2 gas will take place or not. If H2 gas is released, then you can very easily observe that in the beaker in which dilute H2SO4 and zinc granules are taken, bubbles will be formed. If formation of bubble is there, then you can say H2 gas is released. Now, again back to the reaction, Zn plus H2SO4 aqueous. Just compare the reactivity of zinc and hydrogen. As zinc is located on left hand side, so it will be more reactive than hydrogen, or it will be more electropositive than hydrogen. So zinc can displace H2 or hydrogen from H2SO4. Being more reactive, it can displace hydrogen from acid and will combine with sulfate to give you ZnSO4 aqueous, and H will be released in the form of H2 gas. Second case, let us take copper turnings or copper with aqueous H2SO4 or dilute H2SO4. Just compare the reactivity. Copper and hydrogen. Copper is located on right hand side of the hydrogen. So we can say copper is less reactive than hydrogen, or we can say hydrogen is more reactive than copper. So less reactive element cannot displace a more reactive element from its compound. So copper with H2SO4, as copper is less reactive than hydrogen, so copper will not be able to displace hydrogen from here. As a result, no chemical reaction will be observed, or you can say there will be no formation of bubbles in the beaker. So this is application number one. Now application number second, whether the metal will be able to displace another metal from its salt solution or not. We are taking a solid metal with the salt solution. You know it very well. When metallic cations combines with anions, we get salt. CuSO4 is a salt. ZnSO4 is a salt. ZnCl2 is a salt, and so on. So example first, let us mix zinc solate with aqueous solution of iron sulfate or ferrous sulfate. Ferrous sulfate is also called green vitriol because it is a green color solid. When dissolved in water, it will give you green color solution. So zinc is added to green color solution of iron sulfate or ferrous sulfate. Now compare the reactivity. Zinc is located on left hand side of the iron. So zinc is more reactive than iron. So here zinc being more reactive or being more electropositive will displace iron from iron sulfate. As a result, we will obtain ZnSO4 and Fe will be deposited at the bottom of the beaker and you will get somewhat black brown color precipitate. Now color of the solution will also change. The green color of the solution will be converted to colorless because zinc sulfate is called white vitriol, or we can say it is a white color solid. So whenever a white color solid is added to water, we always get colorless solution like NaCl. It's a white color solid. When dissolved in water, you will get a colorless solution. So green color will be converted to colorless. So if color is changing, then we can say that chemical reaction have taken place. So here displacement reaction will take place because zinc is more reactive than iron. Second reaction, Zn solid with copper sulfate solution, aqueous copper sulfate solution. Copper sulfate is also called blue vitriol as it is a blue color solid. When dissolved in water, you will get blue color solution. Now whether the displacement reaction will take place or not, for that we have to compare the reactivity of zinc and copper. So we can take help of metal reactivity series. Zinc is towards left and copper towards right. Means zinc is more reactive than copper. So zinc will displace copper from copper sulfate solution. As a result, you will get zinc sulfate plus Cu solid. Again, you will get somewhat brown color precipitate or solid deposited at the bottom of the beaker. And the blue color solution will be converted to colorless because we are getting zinc sulfate solution. Reaction third, let us mix iron with copper sulfate solution. Again, iron is more reactive than copper. So iron will displace copper from copper sulfate. Iron will combine with sulfate, as a result we will get FeSO4 aqueous and copper will be deposited at the bottom of the beaker. And the color change, which is important, is blue color, not green. Blue color of copper sulfate will be converted to green color. It's blue color here. So if change in color is there, then we can say displacement reaction has taken place or iron has displaced copper from copper sulfate solution. Then the last one, copper solid with iron sulfate or ferrous sulfate. Just compare copper towards right hand side, it means it is less reactive than iron. So copper being less electropositive than iron, or being less reactive than iron, will not be able to displace iron from iron sulfate or ferrous sulfate. As a result, no chemical reaction or no displacement reaction will take place. There will be no change in the color of the solution. That's all in the metal reactivity series. Thank you.